So why do only lionesses hunt? Called the kings of the jungle, ironically, the lion never sets foot in dense rainforests. Their hunting ground is wide open savanna, where everything from zebras to elephants are on the menu. It doesn't sound fair, but the lionesses are probably glad the males aren't around to slow things down. Females are smaller, more nimble, and better organized. They work together as a team, corralling their prey into deadly traps. And when it's time to pounce, their streamlined bodies accelerate to 50 miles an hour in just a few seconds. The lions are much heavier and, truth be told, a bit slow. And with a glorious mane that's easily spotted, well, this guy is pretty useless in a hunting party. So why do the lionesses put up with him? Well, the lazy lump has a very important role to play. Because while the lionesses hunt, he's keeping the families safe and fighting off intruders. In the savannah, circling the pride, are jealous males. These bachelors aren't happy because they have to hunt for themselves. Alone and unable to compete with the lionesses' speed and agility, they are forced to use stealth, hiding in long grass, ambushing anything that gets too close. Ah, too slow this time, Mufasa. They would like nothing more than to get cozy with all these lovely lionesses. Their not-so-secret plan is to oust the alpha male, hook up with the pride, and make their own cute little cubs. If the male succeeds in taking over, something truly horrific follows. To stop the mums from wasting time nurturing cubs belonging to the previous incumbent, the new king of the block will kill the youngsters. Seems cruel, doesn't it? So, to protect the cubs from other jealous males, Dad has to use his bulk, claws, and teeth to fight them off. In fact, the reason the lionesses have latched onto this lazy guy is because he's big enough to protect their cubs from all the other horrible male lions out there. So, how do hummingbirds fly backwards? Found in North and South America, and weighing as little as a penny, hummingbirds' shimmering beauty is eclipsed only by their skill in the air.
They're little fighter jets. They are capable of outmaneuvering any other bird. Their top speed is around 50 miles an hour in level flight. The accelerations they hit, all of that is just, it's amazing what they can do.
But expert Dr. Chris Clark knows the tiny bird's agility comes at a price. Flapping their wings so energetically is hungry work. And if a hummingbird can't refuel at least once every 10 minutes, it will perish. Chris is going to use the hummingbird's insatiable appetite to help him figure out how they fly backwards. He's set up a feeder inside a wind tunnel, which will, hopefully, lure a hummingbird in front of his slow-motion cameras. Camera check, lights check. Okay, cue talent. Meet Louie, a gorgeous Anna's hummingbird, freshly caught this morning.
One of the ways you can tell it's an Anna's hummingbird is from the purple colors on both its throat and on the top of his head.
First, Chris checks to see if Louie can drink the sugar water from the feeder.
Unlike most birds, he figured that out almost immediately.
It's vital that Louie stays still as he feeds, because he has one of the weirdest, most delicate, and relative to its size, longest tongues in nature.
Imagine flying around with an enormous straw on the front of your head, and you had to aim that straw and get it into an exact spot to drink, and yet they're able to do it effortlessly. Oh, here he comes again.
If you scaled up his hairy forked tongue to human size, it would be about 3 feet long, and able to suck up nearly a pint in a second. Sorry, Louis, this isn't a restaurant. It's a wind tunnel.
So I will go ahead and turn it on.
Chris blasts him with a forceful 20-mile-an-hour wind. Louis is so light, he's blown to the back of the cage. Okay, he's back, but just as Chris was hoping, the little rocket is running out of fuel.
The trick is that he has to turn around to go to the feeder, and to do that, he'll have to fly backwards. And we're not sure he can do it at the speed or not. We think he can.
Because of the wind blowing him toward the feeder, Louis will have to fly backwards at 20 miles an hour just to stay still enough to feed on the sugar water. Come on, Louis. Nearly. Come on.
Oh, there we go. Oh, look at that. That is so cool.
Incredible. Chris's slow-motion cameras reveal something amazing. Louis isn't only flapping his wings up and down.
It's a bit different from how other birds do it when they fly.
Most birds produce lift only with the downward flap of their wings. But hummingbirds have borrowed an idea from an unlikely source.
They fly more like an insect does than do other birds.
Insects have more or less a flat wing that they just flap back and forth, and hummingbirds basically do the same thing.
Just like insects, Louis is tracing out a figure eight pattern in the air.
Half the figure eight is made when the wing goes down, and then the other half of the figure eight is when they turn their wing over, and then they go down again in the other direction. And that lets him get thrust both when he flaps his wings down and also when he flaps his wings up.
To go in reverse, Louis simply has to lean back.
When he wants to fly backwards, he has to flap with them tilted up to direct the air backwards so that he goes backwards.
To pull this off, an incredible 25% of Louis's body weight is made up of huge, powerful chest muscles, which allow him to flap his wings an astonishing 80 times a second. Without their hovering superpower, hummingbirds wouldn't be able to gather nectar. The only problem is, hovering uses up so many calories, they have to drain the nectar from 1,000 flowers every day just to keep their engine going. No rest for the wicked, eh?